Hey, what's up, guys? With a How You Blast.
I'm Serge.
And I'm Oscar, and today we are reacting to TXT's new music video for their B-side song, Cat and Dog. It's funny, because when we first saw this, we thought it was a comeback.
Yeah.
Because we didn't listen to the B-sides from this album, sadly. I don't know why. I think it's just because, like, there was a lot of groups that were coming out at the same time, but I say we just get into this
one. Yes, interesting.
I wonder if this will be as simple as Crown or like... Maybe?
I was not expecting that sound.
Okay. Whoa. Okay. I didn't get behind this so far.
Yeah, definitely.
Travis Scott on the beat. Yo, this is lit. I don't know why, but like, I'm just thinking of Travis Scott. This will do. I don't think you know who that is.
Yeah, figured.
He's a rapper from Texas. The lyrics are really funny too. This song is great. I'm a fan. Easy.
Need of my bias. Oh, that's cool.
Wow.
Look like a cat.
That was very interesting, I will say.
I mean, I guess we can start off with rating it.
Honestly, I might give that one a 10. I actually really enjoyed that one, and
I think I'm gonna stick with an 8 on this one.
An 8?
I think it's alright for me. I think it's definitely good enough to make it onto the phone, but I don't think it's something that I'm going to be actively looking forward to listen to, or rather just listen to. So I guess we can rate it.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna give this one a 10, honestly. It was just a really fun song for me, and I just really enjoyed it, really.
Yeah, I think I'm going to just stick with an 8. Mm-hmm. I think it's good enough to make it onto the phone, definitely. But this, you know, as it is a B-side, you know, I never got around to listening to them.
I didn't either, honestly. Like, when I first heard of this, I thought it was a comeback.
Yeah.
Because I didn't listen to the B-sides yet, which I honestly don't know why. I just never got around to it, honestly.
I think it was just a matter of there was too many other title tracks coming out at the time.
There was.
And I personally was focused on some of the other B-sides. I listened to Crown, and I was like, okay, Crown's definitely good enough, so let me just...
I think for me, I was so focused on wondering if I liked Crown or not in the beginning. I totally didn't even think of the B-sides.
Well, like, the way it is with me, when I come across a title track that I find, you know, phenomenal, I just like I kind of push off that album specifically a little bit further back, just so that I don't let the title track, how good the title track, influence the rest of the song. Is when I come across a title track that I'm not super like into, then that's when I dive straight into the actual B-sides, because it's like if I see a B-side that I find more attractive than the title track, I'm gonna be all about it. So that's probably why I never got around to listening to a lot of the B-sides from TXT. But that, I mean, it was dirty good. I prefer Crown hands down, probably, for me.
I don't know. I actually think I prefer this one. Just, I liked the style of this one a lot more, just because, yes, it had a lot more hip-hop influence in it. And when I said it reminded me of Travis Scott, is because the whole brr, brr part, and then when they did the auto-tune, those are just, like, very... it's in a lot of rap, but the way they did it, it just reminded me of Travis Scott. But it was just a really fun song, and I was actually reading the lyrics, or I was trying to read the lyrics along the way, and the lyrics are just really funny. Like,
I just want to be your dog.
I just want to be your dog. But like, it was just a really fun song. That's why I'm giving it a 10.
I mean, I wonder if we haven't listened to the B-sides. I wonder why they chose this one over. I mean, probably because of the title of the song, right? Cat and Dog. They were... Like, when I Imagine Cat and Dog, cutesy, that's the first thing that popped into my head.
I think of the TV show.
That's Cat Dog, yeah. But that's what I thought it was going to be, so I was like, oh man, I don't know how I'm going to feel about this. And then I wasn't expecting it to be this.
Yeah, I wasn't.
So points for that.
Yeah, I had no idea what this song was going to be, and it really reminds me of Mamamoo's song that they did on the, what is it called? It's the one where they're dressed up as animals on the live stage. I can't believe I can't remember this song. What is the name of that song? I don't know, but it reminds me of that kind of, you know.
We're going to remember as soon as we stop recording.
Oh, yeah. That always happens to us.
But this makes me more interested to listen to the B-sides now. And I do actually have time now because recent one that's came back is... BTS and Twice.
I feel like we have a little gap, kind of. Oh My Girl's coming out soon.
I'm excited for that.
NCT.
Ooh.
I think NCT. Not IZ*ONE. No. They just had a comeback. I don't know.
But I mean, after IZ*ONE, Promise is supposed to have a comeback, so waiting on that. Waiting.
It's been a bit, actually, from...
Love Bomb came out in September.
Oh, damn,
October, one of those 2 months.
It has been a while since they came back. Please. But, I don't know, this is just, like I said, is a really fun song, and I don't know, I wonder where this group's gonna go. Like, I wonder, when I say that, I wonder how long it's gonna take them to do their next comeback.
Oh, okay.
That's what I mean.
That's what you mean, okay.
Yeah, because, I don't know, I feel like when you're a rookie... It is really good to, like, promote the shit out of your debut song, but I think it's also a good idea to put out music soon.
I was actually going to ask you that. I mean, do you feel like do you think when a group first debuts, right, do you think that, so let's say they do a title track, right, and then they promote that title track, it does, okay. Do you think that they should head on straight into a different style for a title track? Do you think that they should tackle as many styles as they can in the beginning and then find their sound?
I think it really depends on how solid that first song was. Mm. Like, if there was a lot of good responses from it, but of course it's still not super popular, then I think you should probably just stick with it. If it wasn't really great at all, then you should probably switch it up. But I don't know, some groups just don't do that. Some groups just keep doing the same thing no matter what. And it's like a... it's like a double-edged sword. Like, on one side, you end up getting these extremely loyal fans that will love this group no matter what. Mm-hmm. But on the other side, it's like you won't get a bunch of new fans because you keep doing the same kind of concept. And with TXT, I think just from seeing this kind of style, I think they're going to be a very well-rounded group. And like we haven't listened to the other B-sides, so we actually don't know what the other styles of the songs that they chose were. But just going off of Crown and Cat and Dog, vastly different. I mean, sure, they're still both playful, but I think this one does have more of a current rap. It has a current rap influence in it, and Crown was... I still don't even know how to explain Crown. This is a super fresh, like, great song. Mm-hmm. But I think TXT is going to be a really big group to keep an eye on in the near future. Definitely. Big time. Mm-hmm. But I think that's going to be it for this video, guys. Like always, leave some feedback down below. Hit that like and sub button. And that's all. See you later.